I want to show you something that you won't be able to unsee. On the left-hand side, we have a terminal. On the right-hand side, we also have a terminal. Now, one of these is a native Wayland window, the other is an ex-Wayland window. If I go and resize this one, maybe it doesn't show up super well on the video, so try it out locally yourself. It is going to resize very smoothly. The other one, it's going to feel a tad bit glitchy. Now, depending on the application you use, the result might be better or worse. And here we have a more extreme demonstration. This is the Wayland window. No issue at all. This is the ex-Wayland window. There's clearly something wrong going on this side. This is not just me imagining an issue here. This is an actual problem with the way that rendering is done on Wayland. Or better yet, the way that Wayland interacts with X11 windows through X-Wayland. Now, I wouldn't be surprised if you just never noticed this, because the amount of X-Wayland windows you interact with today isn't very many. You might have some games, which for the most part, you're probably running in full screen or windowed full screen, or in some other way that you're not manually resizing it, and most other things in your system are going to be Wayland now. If something is built in Qt5, Qt6, GTK3, GTK4, and most other toolkits, it's probably going to be Wayland. And whilst this issue was being raised by a KDE developer, the exact same thing happens on GNOME as well. This is a general problem with the way that X-Wayland is interacted with. Now, one of the quickest ways to determine whether a particular application runs using X-Wayland is to resize one of its windows and see how it behaves. If it's glitchy, it's X-Wayland. This can be handy for debugging purposes, but it makes the session look less polished. Now, the other way we can go about doing this is not relying on a bug. What you can do is run an application called X-Prop. If you click on a Wayland window, nothing is going to happen. If you click on an X-Wayland window, you'll get information about how it's running in X-Wayland, all of the various variables attached to it. And one of the goals for Plasma 6.3 is to figure out the problem and get it dealt with so it is no longer an issue people need to think about anymore. Now, the problem here is related to the exact same thing that happens every single time X11 comes up in a discussion. It's because of some legacy thing that just wasn't really thought about long into the future. The X11 frame synchronization protocol. On X11, all window changes typically take place immediately, including resizing. This can lead to some issues. For example, if a window is resized, it can take a while until the application repaints the window with the new size, leading to things like this. What if the compositing manager decides to compose the screen in the meanwhile? You're likely going to see some sort of visual glitches, e.g. the window contents getting cropped or seeing parts of the window that have not been repainted yet. Now, even on X11, they realized this was a problem, and you shouldn't just have windows resizing and putting no thought into making sure there's actually something there to render in the window. To address this problem, there is a protocol called NetWM sync request in the WM protocol's property of the client window, and also set the XID of the XSync counter in the NetWM sync request counter property. Here we are talking about purely X11, purely Xorg, no Wayland is yet involved. The window manager sends a NetWM sync request client message containing a serial the client will need to put in the XSync counter after processing a configure notify event that we generated after the window is resized. The compositing manager and the window manager will block window updates until the XSync request acknowledgement is received. The window manager resizes the client window, for example, by calling the XCB configure window function. The client would then repaint the window with the new size and update the XSync counter with the serial that had received in step one. The window manager and the compositing manager unblock window updates after receiving the XSync request acknowledgement. For example, now the window can be repainted by the compositing manager and there shouldn't be glitches as long as the client behaves well. Obviously, if you have applications that aren't doing their repaints properly, nothing is going to save those, but in the context of a well-made toolkit or a well-made application using its own custom toolkit, if it is doing repaints properly, if it is properly implementing this protocol and getting the repaint ready before it goes and tells it it's ready to do a repaint, everything will look smooth. Now, this is not the problem, but on Wayland, usually the window manager and the compositing manager are the same piece of software. So in the case of KDE, this is Kwin. In the case of GNOME, that is Mudder. In the case of Cosmic, that is Cosmic Comp. Again, as I've said before, very creative name. This kind of frame synchronization is called basic frame synchronization. There is also extended frame synchronization, but it's not standard and it's only implemented by a few compositing managers, so it's not really part of the discussion. We need to work with basic frame synchronization and make it work properly in a Wayland context. Kwin, Mutter, basically everything supports NetWM sync request, so it should support the frame synchronization protocol. And it does, at least on paper, but there are some issues you have with actual implementations. Wayland compositors don't use xcomposite name window pixmap or xcb composite name window pixmap to grab the contents of x11 windows. Instead, they rely on xWayland attaching graphics buffers to WL surface objects, so there is no strict order between the Wayland compositor receiving xsync request acknowledgement and the graphics buffers for the new window size. So the protocol is doing what it's supposed to do within xWayland, but when you're rendering it on a Wayland compositor, the Wayland compositor doesn't actually acknowledge the order things are supposed to happen. Here is a concrete example. Assume that a window with geometry 00, 100 by 100 is being resized by dragging its left edge. If the left edge is dragged 10 pixels to the right, the following will happen. A NetWM sync request client message we sent to the client containing the xsync counter serial that must be set after processing the configure notify event that we generated after the Wayland compositor calls xcb configure window with the new window size. The Wayland compositor calls xcb configure window to actually resize the window. The client receives the sync request client message and the configure notify event repaints the window and acknowledges the sync request. The Wayland compositor receives the sync request acknowledgement and updates the window position to 10.0. But here is the problem. When the window position is updated to 10.0, it's not guaranteed that the WL surface associated with the X11 window has a buffer with the new window size, i.e. 90 by 100. It can take a while until xWayland commits a new graphics buffer. It can take a while until xWayland commits a graphics buffer with the right size. In the meanwhile, the compositor could compose the next frame with the new window position, i.e. 10.0, but using the old surface size, i.e. 100.100. So it'd look as if the right window edge sticks out of the window decoration. After xWayland attaches the buffer with the right size, the right window edge will correct itself. So with these very minor modifications, and with very slow modifications, things are fine. And this is a problem that you can sort of outperform, right? With fast enough hardware, the problem isn't going to be very visible, but all you're doing is hiding the problem and not fixing the problem. And this is a race condition, so some updates might seem fine and others are a problem, and basically, I would argue that kind of makes it look worse. Ideally, what you would have happen is the Wayland compositor should update the window position after receiving the xsync request acknowledgement and xWayland attaching a new graphics buffer to the WL surface, so you actually have the space to render the thing you want to render. Now, because we have the X11 system and then the Wayland system wrapped around that, the model is a little bit more complex, but nothing that isn't manageable. The compositor, that being your Mutter, Kwin, Cosmic Comp, things like that, blocks WL surface commits by setting the xWayland allow commits property to 0 for the top level X11 window. This is needed to ensure consistent order between Xsync request acknowledgement and WL surface commits. As long as Xwayland allow commits property is set to 0, Xwayland will not attempt to commit to the Wayland surface. For example, attach a new graphics buffer after the client repaints the window. The compositor sends a netsync WM sync request client as before. The compositor resizes the client window as before. The client repaints the window and acknowledges the Xsync request as before. After receiving Xsync acknowledgements, the compositor unblocks surface commits by setting Xwayland allow commits property to 0. Note that the window updates are still blocked, i.e. window position is not updated yet. After Xwayland commits the WL surface with a new graphics buffer, the window updates are unblocked, e.g. the window position is now updated. So basically what it's doing is taking the X11 model, making that just continue doing what it's always doing, and then building a sync model in Wayland around that. So it blocks the window, waiting for X11 to do its thing, and then when X11 is done, then it unblocks the window and does all the repaint. Now, it is important to note that if an application doesn't support net WM sync request, nothing is going to help it, right? You can have this whole Wayland model, but if internal in X11 is not doing the whole sync part, it's still not going to be synced. Now, if something is built in a sensible toolkit like GTK or Qt, for the most part, things are going to just automatically have it. Now, whilst the author was definitely involved in fixing the problem, he is not the only one involved in getting it done. He went and reported the problem to Upstream Xwayland and tried to just see what they thought the problem was, whether it was something on the Kwin side or the Xwayland side, and considering he could replicate the problem in GNOME, it was fairly unlikely that both KDE and GNOME were implementing the exact same bug. It's certainly possible, don't get me wrong, but is less likely than there being a problem in Xwayland itself or a problem with the Wayland model. From the discussion here, it led to this merge request over in Kwin: make Xwayland resizing less glitchy. And this basically goes ahead and implements the model that we've been talking about throughout this video. Now, initially, people didn't actually realize it was a problem. Like, Nate couldn't actually reproduce the problem. Turns out he wasn't running the window as a Xwayland window, so of course he couldn't see the problem. Now, the problem has been around basically forever, but the report of the problem is only a fairly recent thing. X11 applications that use net WM sync request do not resize correctly on Wayland. There was also a duplicate report about Chromium. Now, Chromium is a special case because this is one of those applications that doesn't correctly handle net WM sync request. So this solution doesn't actually fix the problem in Chromium. Now, is this one of the worst issues we're facing on Wayland? Absolutely not. For the most part, you're never even going to acknowledge the problem exists. I didn't realize there was a problem until I read the blog post, and now I can't unsee the problem. So, you could live without it being fixed. But, you know, bugs are bugs, and they're still nice to deal with anyway. Let me know your thoughts down below. Did you ever actually notice the bug? And now that I've pointed it out, are you able to unsee it? I would love to know. So if you liked the video, go like the video. And if you really liked the video and you want to become one of these amazing people over here, check out our Patreon, Scribes, Libero Pay, linked in the description down below. That's going to be it for me, and I may have forgotten to record the outro. I'd sometimes do that. Like this.